Thanks for taking time.
My pleasure, sir.
Pathik bhai, we have worked together in a leadership development process. Can you tell something about your early days so that I can make a thread out of it, where you have reached and where do you want to reach in the life?
I can tell you, I have had an amazing childhood. I think it was a kind of a blessing in disguise that we came from a huge house to a very, very tiny home where there was barely any place for people to even sit together.
Mm-hmm.
My father met with some business losses in the old days.
Okay.
It just brought us virtually on the streets. But that childhood, you know, coming from a big house to a place where there were a lot of children, a lot of people to interact with, the moment you step out wasn't an experience in itself. There are a lot of small incidences that are kind of engraved in my mind.
Are these the turning points of your life?
They were all turning points. They were
share all some points. Some of them. Share.
Yeah. So when we came to live in a in this small house, and at that time, around that time, emergency was declared, and there was a day when we were all in the house. It was sort of towards the evening, and there were knocks on the door. And at that time, my father just said, okay, let me just get that, because we didn't know, you know, what it would have been like up until that time. My father opens the door and there is a police force right outside. And my father didn't lose his cool. We knew that he had, you know, had some differences with a couple of politicians who mattered in Gujarat in those days. He had filed cases against them because they were not paying his dues. My father never lost his composure. And it so turned out that in during this process, when the superintendent of police came in, do the
final... Superintendent himself came in?
Yes, yes. And he recognized my father because they were classmates. My father would have lost his cool, would have been escorted, and we wouldn't have known where he's taken to. Because those days, you don't know which jail you'll be lodged in. When he came, we just got a breather, and the superintendent of police said, you know what, I think we'll give you a benefit of doubt because I know you not have done anything wrong. So why don't you just go away from here? What I learned at that time was that if you do not lose your composure,
great.
I think the forces, universal forces, will come to help you. And I also learned at that time that when you're in crisis, be your best. You cannot be your worst when you're in crisis. Similarly, there was a day, and during this period, I'm around 9 or 10 years old. And in those days, there was no mobile phones, no vehicles, and we didn't have a vehicle ourselves as well. So I used to get 10 paisa. I used to board a bus, go to the school. And on my way back, you know, there were times when I'm playing something in the school and I've dropped my 10 paisa coin. And you need to get home. So I would walk 5 kilometers. And every time I would take different routes, just wanting to learn what's there, where I'm going. It just kind of kept helping me all this time, because when you have nothing left, you can still find your way to where you want to go. So these small incidences, I think they helped me.
So I can hear that you have a learning attitude. You create situations where you can learn.
Yeah.
Obviously, I also found you in classroom settings also that you are a great learner. What are one or two or three things which you learned while working on leadership development process?
You know, when I say positivity and probability,
possibility,
you know, and possibilities, everything is there in us. And I always thought that I have it in me. And I always thought that whatever I know has no parallels.
And can you give me one or two examples of creating possibility which has happened in your life?
I will speak about business.
Yes.
So after doing EPED, when we went back and we started realizing ki now I think the world is the possibility. Because tab tak hum India ke andar jo, you know, people continue to think ki hum pehle yahi sochega koi bhi vyapari hoga ki Ahmedabad mein bhej lunga, apne to do dana pani mil gaya to hamara kaam ho gaya. But ek jo, you know, पॉसिबिलिटीज जो ऑलरेडी दिमाग में थी उसको एक दिशा मिल गई और आज हम पूरी दुनिया में बिजनेस करने के लिए तैयार बैठे हुए हैं. आई थिंक दिस वॉज अ टर्निंग पॉइंट. दिस वॉज वट एवर वी लर्न फ्रॉम हियर वॉज पुट इन एग्जीक्यूशन. वी आर राइट नाउ ऑलमोस्ट ऑन द वर्ज ऑफ बाइंग अ कंपनी इन यूके.
Oh, that's great.
We have expanded our network. We have now built a leadership team from within our company and we are now becoming a very tight unit to get things done. Filtration being a niche market, nobody would have thought where we are going right now. But it is all helping us right now. Sambhavnaye.
So I also notice and observe from your words that when you create possibilities, look at possibilities, you also expand yourself in terms of thinking process.
Yes.
As also the organization goes into expansion mode.
Yes.
And that leads to growth.
Absolutely.
That's great. Absolutely. That's a need of an hour.
Yeah.
For the country like ours.
When I used to hear you say, whenever you said, my goal is to create a better India, I now realize how you make that happen.
That's true.
Business people like me, knowing not where to go, and when they really get a direction, they get the motivation, they start seeing a very picture very clearly, that's probably something that will create jobs, that will bring revenues,
sure.
That will reduce the imports,
sure.
People will start manufacturing,
sure.
Here. Aap, jo aap kar rahe ho, I think that is really a very good step in the direction. You know, government can do whatever they need to do. But unless the society ka har ek tapka, अगर उसी चीज को आगे नहीं ले जाएगा तो हाउ विल वी क्रिएट अ बेटर.
दैट्स ट्रू. मेक इन इंडिया इज पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन वी मेक इंडिया.
एब्सोल्युटली.
व्हेन वी हेल्प पीपल बिकम ग्रेट ग्रोथ ओरिएंटेड इंडिया विल आल्सो ग्रो.
अनलेस यू स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट द बिगर ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड देन ब्रेक इट अप इनटू कंपनी सोसाइटी एंड सेल्फ इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क. सो आई थिंक दिस इज समथिंग दैट वाज अ टर्निंग पॉइंट फॉर मी.
Good that you shared that you have growth plans. How do you see the future of you, your organization, your team?
Mujhe ye lag raha hai ki everybody starts seeing possibility is the beginning of the growth.
Absolutely.
So when we decided that we wanted to become a 500 crore turnover company, people were laughing at us. Us samay kuch aur bhi yaad aa gaya ki when people think that my goal is laughable, probably I am on the right track.
Okay, great.
तो ये संभावना, ये possibilities जो थी वो बराबर दिखने लगी हम लोगों को.
Pathik bhai, when I look at data, Indian MSME sector is contributing close to 27% to the GDP. और मेरा जो study बोलता है कि for example Germany में वही small and medium sector करीब 75% से ज़्यादा GDP को contribute करता है. तो मैं पॉसिबिलिटी की दृष्टि से, जो आप बात कर रहे थे, पॉसिबिलिटी की दृष्टि से बहुत कुछ देखता हूँ कि पॉसिबिलिटी है इंडियन सेक्टर को, स्मॉल एंड मीडियम सेक्टर को आगे बढ़ने की. तो आप कुछ मंत्र शेयर करना चाहोगे आपकी लर्निंग के बेस पर?
बहुत सारी जो चीज़ें सीखे हैं दुनिया के अंदर आपके पास से, ऑब्जर्वेशन से, और मैं मानता हूँ कि ऑब्जर्वेशन इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पावरफुल टूल्स, बिकॉज ऑलरेडी हमारे दिमाग में जो बहुत सारी संभावनाएं होती है उसके अंदर ऑब्जर्वेशन से रिफाइनमेंट आ सकता है. मेरा मंत्र बहुत बड़ा नहीं है. मुझे ये लगता है कि अगर आपको जीतना है तो बहुत अच्छी टीम होनी चाहिए और वो टीम इतनी ही डेडिकेटेड होनी चाहिए जितने आप खुद हो. वो इंस्पायर करना वो सबसे बढ़िया बात होगी. दूसरा, मुझे ये लगता है कि आपने अगर गोल बनाया, वो गोल को आपने अगर बांट दिया छोटे छोटे टप्पों में, तो उसके अंदर जो रेवेन्यू का आपका जो टारगेट है उसके ऊपर से हमारी साइड नहीं हटनी चाहिए. तीसरा, मैं हमेशा ये मानता हूँ कि अगर कोई अच्छी बात है तो उसको इमीडिएटली इम्प्लीमेंट करना. कुछ लोग ऐसे होते हैं कि जो सोचते रहते हैं, वो बुरी बात नहीं है.
प्रोक्रेस्टिनेटर भी होते हैं कुछ लोग.
हाँ, बट वो बहुत सोचना और प्रोक्रेस्टिनेशन के बीच में बहुत थिन लाइन होती है. मेरा मानना ये है कि अगर कोई अच्छी चीज है तो उसको उतना ही जल्दी इम्प्लीमेंट करना चाहिए.
पर सीक्रेट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन है.
इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के अंदर ही सीक्रेट है. मुझे ये लग रहा है कि अच्छी बातें तो दुनिया में हर जगह पर है. अगर आप गीता पठन कर लो उसमें भी बहुत अच्छी अच्छी चीजें लिखी है, पर अगर इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं करना है तो उसका कोई मतलब नहीं. और मैं ये मानता हूँ कि बहुत ही अच्छा होगा अगर हर एक पर्सन इन एमएसएमई सेक्टर
अगर इस पर्टिकुलर एथोस को लेकर के चले कि मैं रेवेन्यू का गोल नहीं हटने दूंगा मेरे सामने से, मैं मेरी टीम को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए मेरे से पॉसिबल हर एक संभावनाओं को तलाशता रहूंगा और मैं मेरी जो भी गोल्स सेटअप किए हुए हैं उसको रिव्यू करता रहूं। अगर मैं हर रोज रिव्यू कर सकता हूं,
ट्रैक करता रहूं, परफॉर्मेंस को ट्रैक करता रहूं,
तो हमारी कंपनी के अंदर अभी हम ईयर टू वीक टू डेट, मंथ टू डेट, ईयर टू डेट, क्वार्टर टू डेट, हाफ ईयर टू डेट, ये सारे पर्सपेक्टिव के साथ हम अभी हमारे परफॉर्मेंस को ट्रैक करते रहते हैं। और हमने दूसरा ये भी किया हुआ है, जब हमने ई पोस शुरू किया तब हमें पता चला कि जो भी नंबर्स होते हैं वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं, उसके अगर उसके ऊपर से अगर अपना ध्यान निकल गया,
डेटा इंपॉर्टेंट है,
तो वो काम नहीं बनेगा। तो हर एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के हर एक डिपार्टमेंट के अंदर अभी ना वी आर डेटा सेंट्रिक। तो डेटा से ये हो रहा है कि मान लीजिए कि अगर रिक्रूटर है, एचआर डिपार्टमेंट है, तो एचआर डिपार्टमेंट हैज़ टू गिव अस अ डेटा कि हमने कुल कितने सीवीज देखे, इसमें से
कितने बुलाया,
हमारा कौन सा हेड हंटर अच्छा काम कर रहा है, कितने को हमने इंटरव्यू के लिए बुलाया, कितने
आंकड़े बताएंगे कि हमारी परफॉर्मेंस कैसी चल रही है।
तो अगर एचआर डिपार्टमेंट इतना नंबर फोकस्ड है तो आप सोच सकते हैं कि हमारा अकाउंट्स डिपार्टमेंट तो इससे भी ज्यादा नंबर फोकस्ड है।
Absolutely.
और सेल्स डिपार्टमेंट भी इतना ही नंबर फोकस्ड है। तो इस से ये हो रहा है कि हम अगर कहीं हमारी जो गाड़ी चल रही है एक ट्रैक के ऊपर और थोड़ा इधर उधर हो जाते हैं तो ये नंबर हमें पूरा ट्रैक पर रखता है।
बहुत ग्रेट, थैंक यू प्रतीक भाई। आई एम श्योर दोज हु लिसन टू आवर कॉन्वर्सेशन एंड व्यू आवर कॉन्वर्सेशन विल बेनिफिट। And as I keep saying in the classroom settings that every person has a possibility to become a change agent for somebody else, because it's collective growth which is important for the country and for us. So thank you very much. You shared wonderful thoughts with me. Thank you again.